thing. Just get up and move in whatever way is convenient for you.
Gretchen Reynolds, fifth ed columnist at the New York Times. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks so much for having me.
Thanks for tuning in to Daily Dive Weekend Edition. You can catch a fresh episode of the podcast every morning, Monday through Friday, on iHeartRadio. You can also follow us on social media, at Daily Dive Pod, on both Twitter and Instagram. Stay tuned for the Jesus Christ Show next, but first, into the newsroom. This is KFI AM 640, more stimulating talk.
Wells
is being held in Iowa on $6 million bail and is expected to be extradited to Long Beach. Police say Wells may have gotten into a fight with a man and woman on September 4th, but he did not know them. The fire burning near Gorman off the 5-3 is now 40% surrounded. It started Friday with a big red fire. The fire has burned more than 250 acres. Police and FBI agents are searching in Naples today near Sarasota, Florida, for the fiancé of a missing woman. Northport Police of Josh Taylor says detectives are looking for Brian Landry, who is a person of interest in the disappearance of Gabby Chiquito.
We don't have a phone. We're looking for somebody. That's it. We can't go just pulling people in. We certainly have the Fifth Amendment, not the truth. And, we're respectful of that. We do. We're frustrated.
22-year-old Gabby Chiquito disappeared in August during a cross-country road trip with Landry. Police went to Landry's house on Friday night, but he's now missing too. His family says they haven't seen him since Tuesday. Only a few hundred people showed up for a protest at the Capitol in Washington, D.C. The protest yesterday was over the way people were treated following the January 6th attack on the U.S. Capitol. Organizers say the so-called QAnon shaman is being treated unfairly. There were a lot of police at the rally, and a 7-foot steel fence was put up around the Capitol and the Supreme Court. The SpaceX capsule was back on Earth after splashing down off the coast of Florida. Inspiration 4, on behalf of SpaceX, welcome home to planet Earth. Four people went into orbit Wednesday. They won a 3-day trip on the rocket. It is the first flight with an all-civilian crew to go up into orbit. A jailbreak in Israel that lasted for weeks has finally come to an end.
The final two Palestinian inmates who escaped with an original group of six have been captured in the West Bank. The Israeli army says the two were found today in their hometown of Jenin in an early morning operation. They were the only ones to make it back to the Palestinian-majority West Bank. The other four were caught in northern Israel where the prison is. On September 6th, the prisoners got under the floor of their shared cell into a crawl space, then tunneled the rest of the way out. They've become popular figures for people opposed to Israeli occupation of Palestinian territory. Brian Berman, KFI News.
A flash shot. Wait a minute from the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center. We make it easy. Now we can hit that crash over 10 in Covina. Hours, so you definitely want to avoid the 10 freeway. Hit the 210 or the 60 instead. I talked to Mike on the traffic tip line, pound 250 on your cell phone. He was KFI traffic. He's been sitting there for 20 minutes and can't even get to the 57. That's where they're diverting traffic. The back is first at Dudley. Get off at White Avenue or even at Indian Hill to save yourself lots of time. Like I said, take the 210 or the 60 instead. Good news at the 70 Anaheim by freeway northbound side of Katara. That crash has been cleared from Seabright Lane. KFI on this down helps get you there faster. I'm Rebecca Campbell.
Some cooler temperatures ahead, Matt.
Running a business comes with pressure. With old workforces, HR compliance, retaining top talent, we start to feel boxed in. Fortunately, there's Insperity. They put 30-plus years of HR service and technology to work, offering my employees competitive benefit options while lightening my HR load. Instead of obstacles, I'm surrounded by people empowered to be their best. With Insperity, nothing seems impossible. Insperity. HR that makes a difference.
The Delta variant is making COVID-19 spread faster and more easily. Variants can be more contagious, aggressive, and deadly. But we know vaccines work. Vaccinated Californians have greater protection against serious illness, hospitalization, and death. We can help stop the spread and end the pandemic. Get vaccinated and wear a mask when it can protect you and others. Find a vaccine near you at mychina.ca.gov. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
We've got you covered, America. Go solar American style with Semper Solaris, and we'll cover your electric bill. Semper Solaris is your local veteran-owned solar and battery storage contractor. Add Tesla Powerwall and be ready for blackouts. We get the job done with a free decor and honor. Semper Solaris offers new AC systems with a lifetime warranty and new roofs with a 50-year warranty. We hire vets and give back to the community with our Semper Cares initiative. Go solar American style with Semper Solaris, and we'll cover your electric bill. Zero down, zero interest, and zero payments until 2023. Get the federal 26% solar and battery tax credit. $500 off for military, first responders, and healthcare workers. Call 877-211-5591. That's 877-211-5591. Or visit SemperSolaris.com.
With minimum purchase of 10 panels, up to $500 paid for an electric bill. Cannot be combined with any other offers. Some restrictions apply. Call us to website for details. Expires 9/31/11. ESLV number 978152.
For eligible individuals, 18 or older only, not available in Oregon or West Virginia, results vary. See website for details and important safety information.
How are you hearing aids sounding now?
A little tinny.
Okay, 2 seconds.
Your hearing aids from Lively. Everything is done remotely in the comfort of your home, from initial testing to adjustment.
How are they sounding now?
Fantastic. So much better. With Lively, you get premium Bluetooth-enabled hearing aids at thousands less than you might expect. The best hearing aid technology is now affordable and convenient. Your hearing aids are sent right to your door, and if you have any issues, we'll make adjustments 7 days a week, no charge. Aw, these people at Lively are wonderful. With Lively hearing aids, you get free shipping, 3 years of follow-up care included, free, plus a 3-year warranty with loss and damage coverage. You can't lose. Are you better than I ever thought possible? Now get $100 off your hearing aids when you go to listenlively.com/radio. That's listenlively.com/radio. listenlively.com/radio.
Southland weather from KFI, partly cloudy skies for your Sunday. Highs around 70 for the beaches. Upper 70s for Metro LA and Inland OC. Mid to upper 80s in the valleys and IE. Upper 80s in the high desert, low 70s in the mountains. Starting tomorrow, temperatures in the low 80s for the basin and OC. Low 90s for the valleys and IE for much of the week. Fall officially begins on Wednesday. Right now it's 56 in Robalinda, 56 in San Clemente, 60 in Venice Beach, 58 in Reseda. We leave local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Layla Mahoney.
The following is a pre-recorded program. Over 2,000 years ago, I walked this earth. Teaching, healing, inspiring, and preparing to meet the ultimate sacrifice. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. What if today you and I could talk voice to voice, and you could ask me anything? You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. Answering your questions and talking about the things that truly matter in life, and especially the afterlife. I encourage you to be bold and berating and your phone with your theology question or life situation question anywhere in the U.S. Better Ghetto, 800-520-1534. That's 800-520-1534.
You know, change is inevitable, and life is. It's going to happen. Change will come in many different forms, in many different ways, and enter your life through front doors, back doors, and windows. And you can choose to be on the side of fear, running from any sort of change in your life, or you can embrace it and seek the things that God has for you in those changes. Scripture is clear that when it comes to God, there is no change. God does not change. Malachi 3:6, I, the Lord, do not change. James 1:17 says, every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly light, who does not change like shifting shadows. And of course, I don't change. Wow. Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. But does that mean that the change is bad? If, you know, if God doesn't do it, then you shouldn't like change, or you shouldn't embrace change, or that you shouldn't change? Absolutely not. It simply means God doesn't change because there's no need for him to. But there is a need for you to change, and there is a need for you to experience transformation from time to time. And other people will change around you, and other things will change around you, and in this process you will be affected. People will go through things around you, and that will affect you. People will come in and out of your life, and have certain needs around. You'll lose people in your life. Due to sickness, death, things will motivate you to maybe move or live in new territory. There will be job changes, whether you want them or don't want them. There'll be changes in work structure, home structure, friendship structure. And these changes often occur whether you want them to or not. I've spoken to many people on the air here that call up and say, there's something going on in my church, or my pastor changed. My pastor left and moved somewhere else, and I don't know if I like the new pastor, or I don't like the new way things are being done, or whatever it might be. Change will come in your life. And as I said, sometimes that change will happen to you, or sometimes it happens around you. But it always happens because there is a plan. It always happens in a way that even if God does not cause the change, God allows the change and has a positive or productive outcome for that change. When it happens to you, it's usually because, as Scripture says, you're shedding the old you, your old ways, your old understanding, and you're welcoming the new and improved you. You're spiritually molting, if you will. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here. To embrace that, to understand that that is of God, to understand that God is in change, not because God changes, because he does not, but because life will bring change. Circumstances will change. We say that all the time on the program about life situations, and we call them life situations because they will change. If something can go from good to bad, it can go from bad to good. I know it doesn't feel that way, and when you're in the middle of it, you wrestle with it. But I want you to find the beauty of change, the importance of change, as God puts it around you everywhere, in the seasons, the colors, times from day to night, age as you grow, and that metamorphosis that is at the very crux of life. The changes that happen around you can also have wonderful effects on you. If you adhere to God's will, if you focus on what God wants in your life, you focus on God's will and you don't give in to fear,
because the fear in this case comes from the enemy. The enemy wants you to fight off that change and the things that God has for you. Most people, when asked about change, and maybe this is you as well, say they don't like it. Maybe you don't like change in your life. Most people bristle at the thought of having change or things shifting in their life in any way, shape, or form. It's because most people like to stay in their comfort areas, their comfort zone, doing things the way they always have been done. You like that repetition. This is the way it's done. This is the way you've always done it. This is how you like it. And that's fine to have likes or dislikes. It's fine to have comfort to a degree. Don't sit in fear of change just because you want to be in that comfort zone, because sitting in your comfort zone can cause you to become complacent and both physically and emotionally lethargic, lazy, unmotivated to seek different things, unmotivated to grow as a human being, unmotivated to be in that state of understanding, knowing that you have to be fluid in life because things will change around you. It's not about where you go in life and the things that you go to and the changes in the past, as much as it is who you're traveling with that's important. Joshua 1:9 says, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened and do not be dismayed. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." So regardless of whatever path comes up your way, regardless of the things that change in your life or shift around, to know that God is with you is what's important. That focus of knowing that even in the change, God is there. Because the change happens, but God doesn't change. God uses change for growth, to motivate you, to get you out of those comfort zones so that you can see things differently. God commands you to change for the better. Actually, your entire faith is birthed from change and a renewing of who you are and an understanding of what God has for you in this world. Luke 13:3, "No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all likewise perish." And to repent means to change or to turn from your old ways. And you hear that all the time, repent, the end is near. It's about changing from your old ways, embracing the newness that God has for you. Those who don't do that, those who rebel, God will punish. God will punish those that are prideful, those that refuse Him and refuse to change, to repent, and to seek the things of God. Psalm 55:19 says, "God will give ear and humble them, He who is enthroned from the old, because they do not change and do not fear God." Isn't that interesting that the concept of change for humans comes out of a fear of God, not the change? So you can be on one of two sides. You can look at change and be fearful of the change, but know God is there for you. Or you can be fearful of the change and think God's not going to be there for you. In Psalm 55:19, it points out that those that don't change do it because they don't fear God. Isn't it better to fear God than fear the change? Things will come about in your life, and they'll throw you for a loop from time to time. The key is to be not focused on the things that are wavering, the things that are changing in your life, but focus on the God who is not.
You are listening to the Jesus. This report is sponsored by Allstate. Looking to save money this year? Look at Allstate. You can get the protection you need at the low rate you want. With Allstate, you can lower your rates, not your expectations. Visit Allstate.com or call an agent for a quote today.
I am one of thousands of women with metastatic breast cancer, or MBC,
which is breast cancer that has spread to other parts of the body.
I am living in the moment and taking Ibrance Salpocyclib.
Ibrance 125 milligram tablets with an aromatase inhibitor is for postmenopausal women or for men with HR-positive, HER2-negative MBC as the first hormonal-based therapy.
Be in your moment. Ask your doctor about Ibrance and visit Ibrance.com. Ibrance may cause low white blood cell counts that may lead to serious infections. Ibrance may cause severe inflammation of the lungs. Both of these can lead to death. Tell your doctor right away if you have new or worsening symptoms, including trouble breathing, shortness of breath, cough, or chest pain. Before taking Ibrance, tell your doctor if you have fever, chills, or other signs of infection, liver or kidney problems, are or plan to become pregnant, or are breastfeeding. Common side effects include low red blood cell and low platelet counts, infections, tiredness, nausea, sore mouth, abnormalities in liver blood tests, diarrhea, hair thinning or loss, vomiting, rash, and loss of appetite.
Prescription products require online consultation. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information.
Think you might have ED? Not sure? Well, we'd like to let you in on a little secret. ED is common. About 40% of men experience ED by age 40. But the solution is simple. Find it at forhims.com.
I didn't have to talk to a doctor in person. There was no copay, and the medication was shipped right to my door in discreet packaging.
Hims took care of it. Fast and easy. Now our love life is better than ever. Get access to doctors online who can prescribe you FDA-approved ED medication if appropriate. The same active ingredient as name brands, but 90% cheaper. Skip the waiting rooms and pharmacy lines. Get a free medical consultation and rise to the occasion or your money back. Go to forhims.com/join to get your first visit free. No copay required. The only way to get this special offer is to go to forhims.com/join. forhims.com/joy. There are some great TV series we would have never seen without VidAngel, like Breaking Bad, Virgin River, and Bridgerton. VidAngel is a fantastic technology that lets our family watch these shows while filtering out the nudity, profanity, and gore. So we didn't miss out on hot new series like Outlander and The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, which was hilarious. VidAngel works with your streaming services and lets you customize the settings to skip and mute the content you choose to avoid. And it's so smooth, you hardly notice it while you're binging on Bosch and Jack Ryan. Oh, we love Jack Ryan. Not only do we see shows that we would have otherwise missed, but we enjoy them more. And we can even watch many of them with our kids without cringing every few minutes. Go to getvidangel.com and use the code RADIO1 and you can get a month of VidAngel for only $1. And did I mention the Queen's Gambit? That was awesome. And Stranger Things. Well, you get the picture. Let VidAngel make media better for your family and start enjoying your shows tonight.
Finding savings in your prescriptions can get confusing. So CVS built a tool that looks for ways to lower your costs. Ask your pharmacist how you can save. That's Healthier Made Easier from CVS. Savings vary. Not all patients eligible for savings. Ask pharmacist for details.
Get your daily dose of California with the Times Daily News from the LA Times. Join your host, LA Times journalist Gustavo Arellano, as he unpacks our world with a West Coast perspective. Listen and subscribe today at latimes.com/the Times or wherever you get your podcasts.
Being on the 10th freeway westbound side just past Kellogg, there's a fatal crash investigation. All lanes are shut down till possibly 8 o'clock this morning, and your drive is backed up already coming away from Dudley. Get off at White Avenue and head northbound over towards Arrow Highway or southbound to Holt. That will save you some time, or take the 210 or the 60 instead. And in Torrance, 110 freeway northbound side just before you get to Sepulveda Boulevard, crews have lanes stopped so they can put out a tree fire. Traffic is at a standstill right now at 223rd. Kfi Am, if I help get you there faster, I'm Rebecca Campbell.
Oh, yeah, it's you.
Christ Show. I am your holy host. Happy to be with you this Sunday, as I'm with you every single Sunday right here, answering your questions and talking about the things that truly matter in life, and of course the afterlife. I encourage you to be bold and brave and go to the phone with your theology questions or life situation questions anywhere in the U.S. of A. Dial 800-520-1534. That's 800-520-1534. Scripture makes it very clear that God does not change. God is immutable. God will not change. I do not change. I am the same yesterday, today, and forever. That is clear. But you do change. You will go through change. Part of your change of faith, becoming a new creature in God, involves that change. And those changes are important. Throughout the entirety of Scripture, you see the importance of making that change and learning and growing in God. And my own words in the New Testament, you see and read about the importance of change and becoming that new creature. That new creature in Christ, that one that sheds the old self and embraces the new. That change is important. But also, so are the changes that happen around you. Sort of seasons of change that come and go in your life that often make you a little nervous or make you concerned about the direction of your life. And I want you to know that God is in those changes as well. God may not do every change in your life, but God allows every change. The enemy may try and put changes in your life and sadness and sorrow, but God can use those things for his glory. God commands you to change for the better throughout life. You're to shed those old ways of thinking, the old things that you do. And you need to think of the change like seasons. You need to know that that God is with you, and as the change happens, you may be thinking only about the change, but you need to think about the God that sustains you. God says in Scripture the change is all around you, that it's inevitable. These seasons of change may be uncomfortable, but they're always important. They're always purposeful. You'll always have these different seasons throughout your life. Ecclesiastes, it's been made into songs. You've heard Ecclesiastes 3 over and over, but there is a time for everything. A season, every activity under heaven. You'll be born, you'll die. There's a time to plant, there's a time to harvest. There's a time to tear down something, a time to build, a time to weep, a time to laugh. A time to be sad and mourn. There's a time to dance and be happy. The time where you scatter. There's a time where you gather. Times of tearing and mending, times of silence, times of speaking, times of love, times of hate, times of war, times of peace. All throughout Scripture, these things take place. There is always change. It's part of what you'll go through in life. And these seasons are an important part of it. Change should be embraced. You don't want to rush through these things. You want to embrace them, knowing that God will bring you through. Ecclesiastes points out that there are seasons, there are changes in life, and that all things should be experienced with the proper perspective, knowing that God is with you. Change in your life is actually a gift from God. Cherish it. Learn from it. Grow from it. Don't fear it, and don't hide from it. You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. To ask your question, dial 800-520-1534. All of my life and my whole life has
been. I'm Layla Muhammad, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The first West Nile virus-related death of the season has been confirmed in Los Angeles County. Officials say that the person who died was a resident of the eastern region of the county and has been in the hospital with a neuroinvasive disease. 10 cases of the mosquito-borne virus have been reported in Los Angeles County so far this year.
An Amber Alert has been canceled. Police say the kids allegedly abducted by their father in Riverside County are safe in Modesto. The Amber Alert was issued late Friday night for the two children, 9-year-old Gino Castillo and 5-year-old Memphis Zaco. The Modesto Police Department says the kids and their father were found at a local hotel and the kids are okay. Texas Governor Greg Abbott has signed a $2 billion bill to increase border security in his state. Abbott said Texas is stepping up to do what the federal government is supposed to do. The bill will fund state troopers and National Guard members to police the border and possibly build a fence. More than 10,000 migrants are camped out under a bridge in Del Rio, Texas, waiting to be processed by the Border Patrol. The Biden administration is apparently getting close to putting out a plan to send those migrants, who are mostly from Haiti, back to their homeland. Let's check in on a crash in Covina on the 10th.
This fatal crash investigation is westbound on the 10th freeway just past Kellogg. They have all lanes of the freeway shut down, and they are diverting traffic to the 57 in either direction. Your backup starts at Dudley, but you can get off at Indian Hill, head northbound to Arrow Highway or southbound to Holt and use the service streets, or the 210 and the 60 would be good alternates for you as well. They got the street fire out in Torrance, 110 freeway northbound side just before you get to Polo Boulevard, so all lanes are open and you're looking at good speeds there, and that's clear for you all the way into South L.A. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Rebecca Campbell.
Excellent.
Southland weather from KFI. Partly cloudy skies today with highs around 70 along the coast. Upper 70s for Metro LA and inland OC. Mid to upper 80s for the valleys and the IE. We lead local live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Layla Muhammad.
This is my business. I started it and my hard work made it successful. We survived the last year and things are starting to look better, but now hard work alone isn't enough. I need cash to hire some people and buy supplies.
Loan Me Business is for people like you. We can loan your business from $6,000 up to $250,000. And we understand that you don't need the cash soon. You need it now. And if your credit isn't perfect, that's okay. Apply today and you can have the money in your account tomorrow. Loan Me Business loans have longer terms, keeping your monthly payments low and manageable. You can even pay the loan off early to control your costs with no prepayment penalties. That sounds great. Simply go to loanmebiz.com to get started. That's loanmebiz.com or call 844-3-LOANME.
Not all applicants are qualified. Approval and terms subject to credit standards. See loanme.com for details. Loans made pursuant to California Department of Financial Protection and Innovation Law License 603K061.
That's 844-3-LOANME or loanmebiz.com.
Before I started Rooter Hero Plumbing, I was an angry young man. Hello, I'm John Aquian. I was angry because my dad died when I was 17 and he left me alone. I was angry because I couldn't go to college with my friends and because I had to drop out of high school. It's not a pleasant story. But as I grew older, I also grew up. I realized that my dad didn't leave me alone. He left me with values and principles that continue to shape my life. Dad said be on time. He didn't like it when people were late. He taught me to be polite. It was something I lost, but recaptured along the way. And he taught me to keep my promises, because broken promises lead to broken relationships. We teach and keep these values at Rooter Hero Plumbing. I think we have a pretty good company. I know we have great people. And if one of our heroes fails to live up to these values, please call me. My private number is on the back of every Rooter Hero business card. You can also reach